This is Cynthia Sue Larson with realityshifters.com talking with you today about quantum supremacy, quantum time, and quantum rules. Google has been in the news in 2019 for the idea that they are on the brink of announcing quantum supremacy. That phrase, in the realm of quantum computing, simply means that it's going to be expected that we can verify quantum computers actually are faster at some operations than classical computers. This has not been proven yet, but it's expected to be proven quite soon. Now, when I hear the term quantum supremacy, I tend to think in terms of the phrase that's on my shirt here, which says, "No return to classical reality." This is, in fact, the name of a paper that was written in 2013 by David Jennings and Matthew Leifer, and the idea in their paper is that at a fundamental level, the classical picture of the world is dead, and has been dead now for almost a century. Now, these are fighting words, these are brash words, but they are fully backed words by the demonstration that these two made, that there do exist fundamental phenomena of quantum theory that cannot be understood in classical terms. And as the authors state, we now have a range of precise statements showing that whatever the ultimate laws of nature are, they cannot be classical. I've touched on this topic before, and in fact I've written a paper of my own called Primacy of Quantum Logic in the Natural World, which goes into a lot more detail as to why I really feel that quantum supremacy is not just in the realm of computers, but in fact will be seen everywhere. And I'm absolutely thrilled by the prospect of considering classical reality to be simply a special case that can be calculated within quantum physics, quantum mechanics. And so I see that we're unquestionably now in the quantum age, which brings us to the next topic I'd like to bring up, which is quantum time. Now in 2019, the mind-boggling recent discovery that true quantum supremacy along the lines of no return to classical reality also seems to be demonstrated in the realm of time itself. Physicists at the Stevens Institute of Technology, the University of Vienna, and University of Queensland announced in 2019 that particles aren't the only ones capable of existing in a state of superposition. You'll remember this is a quantum phenomena, quantum principle, quantum property, if you will. However, it's now been determined that when these scientists were able to observe quantum temporal order, the sequencing of events, they reported in the August 22, 2019 issue of Nature Communications that quantum properties of time exist such that cause and effect can exist both in a forward and backward direction. So, if time itself is quantum, what about other areas? Well, another existing belief or assumption, rather, about reality is that we can definitely have this so-called quantum realm. And that's where there's this dividing line that people have hypothesized that must exist, where we can ignore quantum properties and principles and behavior and just do the classical computations, keep it simple in that very simplified special case world. But this exciting announcement came forth from the University of Vienna, Austria. Marcus Arndt and his team announced in a paper they published in September 2019 that even huge molecules are following the quantum world's bizarre rules. And what they did is they noticed that there is not so much of a seam as they might have thought, because they're able to get those same kinds of diffraction patterns, if you will, like you might see with the double slit experiment, even with gigantic particles. That wasn't supposed to happen, but it's happening. And so what I'd like to close and conclude today with is the thought that those of us who are experiencing the Mandela effect, reality shifts, quantum jumps, all of that, where we notice that our thoughts and feelings appear to have some effect on the physical world, we might start noticing that we can expect that we're going to find some scientific explanations that this type of phenomena can be expected to naturally occur, that it is an integral part of recognized scientific models, and that it's absolutely necessary in order for life and reality as we know it to exist at all. So until next time, keep thinking about what it means to you, quantum rules, quantum time, quantum supremacy. Keep asking, how good can it get? This is Cynthia Sue Larson with realityshifters.com.